Bookmark that site, folks, because YouTube may soon go completely vanilla on you.
I got my price. It's $846 million. Mm-hmm. And that's the budget for six ships, in my estimate.
So everybody's got a price, Matt. I think your audience wants to know, why have you extricated yourself from Hollywood? And it's probably not your own choosing, I imagine.
No,
But number two, the other question, the most formidable question is that, what is your tipping point? Well, every man has a price. You have a price too.
Well, it's so fun. This whole project, I've already exposed my price. It's $846 million. Okay. And that's the budget for six ships and six teams, in my estimate, what we'll need to go across Antarctica completely, not just to the pole
straight
that
line.
Told us.
Straight line.
Yeah,
in
from
theory.
Six different entry points. And we should all intersect at a certain point or within a certain amount of time and then continue. And then reach the coast if it's a ball, which, you know, and it's kind of interesting. They're kind of like painting themselves in a corner, if I could use that pun. I mean,
one of the four corners, right?
Well, you know, one of the four corners of the world. They're painting themselves into a corner because now it's like, who wouldn't look at that film of these six teams?
Right.
Look at the metrics. We're like hundreds of millions of people worldwide are like now investigating whether or not the globe is a fraud. Do you know how many people would go to the theater? Do you know how many people would watch that or pay-per-view real time? Every day, I want to see where they're at. I'll pay $2 every day because it's a real time capture and transmission and broadcast back to casinos. So you got the people downloading to see it. You got the casinos broadcasting it for free, but you got to bet on it, or people bet on it. And so you got the betting money. You got the people downloading this as a real-time event to watch it, mm-hmm. and all the drama in six different competing expedition models. One saying a ball, one saying it's hollow, one saying it's a flat dome and they want to hit the glass wall, the other saying there's more land.
So
two of those, actually.
You're talking about adopting the survivor model.
I'm saying this thing is at a point right now with the demographics and the amount of people watching this and the fact that they're buzzing the Flat Earth now on talk shows why isn't there a producer stepping up to me going, you know what, I want to film your expedition, we want to give a budget, we want to set you up with a meeting with the Antarctic Treaty members to have you at the seat at the board, we want to have your idea of having these briefcases full of cash that paid for the in cash
their
the bond of 600 people because they want 60,000 per individual to do the crossing,
right? It's
the treaty members want 60,000 for a double traverse crossing.
The penultimate host.
Like, how come nobody's coming up to me?
It's the penultimate.
How come nobody's coming up to me?
Game show. Like,
and yet
remember Running Man from the Arnold Schwarzenegger days?
It's the penultimate.
Movie?
It's the last place we didn't go. Went to the moon before somebody went across with
lost
a bunch of witnesses.
J.J.
It's
Abrams.
Everything. It's like there's more land. It's Mockingjay.
People
it's Hunger Games.
Exactly.
It's The Matrix.
Everybody's subconscious.
Like it's actually their formula that they employ in a Hollywood story.
Make it a
story.
Game show. Who wants to be a millionaire? Look how popular that is.
Oh, and then the
come on,
the,
Hollywood.
The casting of
this
who's going to be on each
idea.
Team. The casting of who's going to be on each team. So the globalists, we send them the camera and they're going to see who's going to be part of their 100-man crew.
You could have the best photographers on earth, the best cinematographers from National Geographic to ABC.
A
NBC,
unifying moment.
Viacom. Like
people from around the world.
Producers, the greatest directors, right?
People from around the
they
world.
They should be salivating over this. Where's the tipping point? You laid out the number.
Well, they're proving that the Earth is flat by ignoring that this is probably the most lucrative film project production and event that people could bet on intellectually. And the best and the greatest unifying moment for all of us to realize we're all together here, wherever we are. And we're going to go where no man has gone before. Not a few guys with the same ring and the same handshakes back in 69 and not back again since 78 or 79.
Sure.
2017, technology is supposed to be increasing and getting better. You can't say we can't replicate what we did in the 60s.
Right.
It's like the only technology that hasn't improved is aerospace. That makes no sense. Hmm. And why is the Concorde gone? Why did they decommission the Concorde? Because they knew it was coming. I was around, by the way, and doing these shows in comedy clubs, and we'll get to the comedy.
I remember the Concorde.
Yeah, but I was already going around affecting people by the thousands doing these live shows, sneaking them in, and like, what's he doing tonight? What the? Where is he going? Going from nuclear weapons and saying vaccines are a joke,
to the
and
flags.
That stupid body exhibit that the guy's going around with cadavers.
About the flags, man.
The flags?
Yeah.
Yeah. Aerosol spray.
That was so funny, man. You talk about the flags. Oh, the little caricature flags. Oh, yeah.
Flaggots. We call them flaggots. People waving
the little flag. Not to show any disrespect to people who believe in patriotism, but, you know.
Patronosis.
You're coined a new term there.
Patriotism.
You
like that?
I like it. Very salient. Very salient. But, yeah. But the... Okay, so my question. I don't want to get...
Infiltard is another one. Infiltarded. Infiltard. there was another one that came up. Patronosis, infiltardic, infiltard.
For dyslexia, because it's like the same
story. So he's infiltrating, but in a very retarded way.
But here's the question. Here's another semi $500,000 question. Okay, so is there a focus group that Hollywood could maybe bring into a room, like an OJ jury?
I think.
And you could bring in people who believe in the flat earth, and you could say, how many in your family
or know the flat earth?
So that they could do an extrapolation to figure out what the marketing, the audience, the actual number.
Well, you can get the metrics.
Population that believes in that.
Well, you can get the metrics.
Because that's how you got to sell this, right?
Well, here's what's interesting.
How many people are going to tune in to pay-per-view?
Here's where there's holes in the whole thing, like the way they're reacting to it. You can get the metrics from YouTube. You just type in flat earth on YouTube and you go today's search result.
Yeah.
And you'll see how many videos are up. You know, you go, wow, there's like 10 million. Yeah, you can do that.
So you go
10 million videos.
Search and you can find out
how many videos are up on the topic.
Based on a keyword search? Yeah,
but here's the problem.
I didn't know.
They've been rolling back the total amount. So they're rolling back the fact that Hollywood will be more and more obvious as an ideological asset to this indoctrination military industrial academia
complex. But that appeals to the audience that's already on board with flat earth. How are you going to draw in more audience members who are on the fence about, it might be flat earth?
It's spreading. Once you start measuring.
How do you galvanize that audience that's already...
They're being galvanized.
To where you're not proselytizing. You bring them in as if it's like a new game show. Like, who wants to be a millionaire? That's a non-threatening type of TV show. Of course, I want to be a millionaire.
Well, the ones that are most adamant about the curve.
Without any dogma brought into it. Well, everybody loves money, right?
Well, dogma. Dogma is something that you can't universally prove and you'll hold as true.
Yeah.
So that would be the earth is a ball, because we can't all get that point of view.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So that becomes... So
it's
then
faith. That's a
it's
faith
reduced
face.
To religion. And then on top of it, we now discover when you have close examination, these are paintings or composite images. And then they have to redress in small print, artist rendering, composite image, you know.
Sure. And this is well understood. You can go on any JPL website or Soho.com.
Oh, they'll admit that they don't have real-time footage of the earth doing one rotation. But then they'll also admit that we get our images from a geostationary satellite that's filming the Earth 22,000 miles away. So it's like, what is it? So you can you just call up NASA, Shaq, and tell them to turn on the camera? Tell them to turn on the camera, Shaq.
He certainly has the power. He has the position.
He has the power to call up or at least get on the phone and film it and put it on YouTube and go, you know what? I can't get NASA to turn on the camera. Right now, we're fusing now comedy, rock, preaching, into a real-time assault on the globe.
Math, preaching.
It's like, performance.
Do you speak from your heart when you say preaching? Like,
I think blues. I think the ultimate preacher should be a blues man.
But what do you mean by preaching, though? Like
preaching, like, you know, when these... I've seen some
preaching
very...
message of...
What, the preacher, the man on the pulpit. The man on the pulpit. I saw one of the best theologians. See, you could be a theologian that's just writing scripts. But if you're a theologian that can communicate to a crowd, philosophy, like there's, I think the best philosophy teachers are preachers, right? The preacher is
basically
the preacher is the passionate philosopher.